Hi everyone, I'm Damon McCool, Public Programming Specialist at Eastern State Penitentiary. Welcome back to Prisons in the Pandemic, where we examine the ways COVID-19 is impacting the lives of incarcerated people, correction staff, prison administrators, and other stakeholders within the criminal justice system. Let's take a look at one story making headlines this week. A federal judge has ordered California to take several steps aimed at curtailing the rapid spread of COVID-19 throughout its prisons. The judge's order mandates that each state prison in California allocate at least 100 beds for incarcerated people with COVID-19 in an effort to isolate those with the virus from those without it. According to the order, the state must also take into consideration the needs of prisoners with disabilities and those with a mental illness. Some incarcerated people with disabilities have told lawyers they are being housed near people with COVID-19, and as a result, fear for their well-being. It was reported last week that roughly half of all incarcerated people who have died from the virus in California had disabilities. Lawyers advocating on behalf of incarcerated people and their families called the judge's order a big step toward preventing further COVID-19 flare-ups in state prisons. Now, many states have adopted new policies to slow the spread of the virus, such as considering the needs of incarcerated people with disabilities, or releasing elderly incarcerated people. Which of these policies, if any, do you think states will continue to practice once COVID-19 is no longer the biggest threat facing people living in prisons and people working in them? We look forward to your questions and comments. Thank you for tuning in. We'll see you next time on Prisons and the Pandemic.